Hello guys, in this video I'm going to talk about 360 video and 360 cameras, what I think about it, and whether it's something you can actually use for professional work. So as you can see up here, these are just some of the 360 cameras that I have used. These are cameras that I own. There's been others that I've borrowed or rented. And some of these I bought, some of them were sent in to me. This one actually that I'm going to talk about mostly, which is the latest one, is the Insta360 1X, was actually sent in to me by the company. They did not pay me to review this. They just simply said, hey, try it out, let us know what you think. I have tried their previous one, which is the Insta360 One, and there was good and bad, but at the end of the day, just like with all these other cameras, I just did not think it was worth, for me, spending time with these cameras. Now that all changed with the Insta360 1X, and the reason is because this is, I think, the first 360 camera on the market that is actually has, it's kind of borderline usable quality. Because these other ones, they were recording like in 4K, this one also records in 4K, the OMI one, and it's not quite 360, it's a VR camera, but it's actually 240 degrees. This one is 360, but the quality just, I think, wasn't even the same resolution as what Samsung claimed it was. At the end of the day, basically, for 360 video, in case you didn't know, you're easily recording, and like in this case, you can see you have these two cameras here everywhere like that. You're basically recording on two different cameras, and then you're kind of wrapping that image around a virtual sphere, so you can then, in a, let's see, if you have VR goggles, you can look around, or in your editing software, you can kind of look around and pick your angle afterwards. And so that means that if you're recording, let's say, 4K footage, well, that doesn't mean that your final videos are going to be 4K. It's not even going to be 1080p once you pick your angle and once you zoom in, especially to that part of that 360 sphere. And so that's kind of the reason why, I would say the main reason why, up until this point, 360 video, especially in these affordable kind of cameras, just was not up to the quality. This camera changes it because it's 5.7K. And I managed to do this, and as you can see, this tiny little camera. So you can record 5.7K video. And I think this is like, it's still the bare minimum. I would definitely not go lower than that. So I hope in the future, manufacturers of 360 cameras can step up their resolution. But I think this is like the bare minimum of acceptable resolution. Because I've tried again with all these other cameras, and it never really looked good. So with this camera, I've been using this actually as my sort of a home video camera when I've been traveling with my family, and it's great for that. If you're looking for just a good home video camera, something that you can just click, you know, the record button and forget about it, I think this is the camera for you, because it's very simple to use. Let me just show you. You have two buttons on the front. Smaller one is the power button. Bigger one here is your record button. So once you start it up, right now in photo mode, I can just click it and takes a photo for me. If I click it again, I can cycle through the camera, the video mode, or the settings mode. So now I'm in video mode, and again, press the record button and it's recording. And the great thing is, once you're recording, again, you're recording in 360, everything around, so you can kind of forget about it, because you don't have to worry about pointing the camera and all that stuff. Afterwards, in your editing software or on your phone, you can later on decide and pick the angle that you want. And maybe that's kind of how I'm going to break this down. Kind of first, just talk about the camera itself and then the post-production aspect, because there's some very good and some very, I would say, bad things about this camera and in general about 360 cameras. So as far as recording, it's actually pretty simple. Like I said, two buttons. You see all your settings up here, shows you the resolution, you know, how long you've been recording. Press the button again and it stops recording. You press the power button again to cycle to the settings, and then press the big button to go through the different settings. So if you want to, you know, adjust some settings within the camera, that's how you would do it. It's pretty straightforward, as you can see, when it comes to recording it. And that's, I think, how especially a good home video camera should be, because it's something that you want to, again, set it, forget it, and just kind of go about your life and let the camera capture all that for you. If you get this camera, I would highly recommend getting this accessory, which is this kind of a selfie stick that they offer. It's pretty straightforward. You just attach it. But the big difference between this and like those cheesy cell phone selfie sticks is that with this thing, first of all, it works very great. You just turn it and it allows you to extend it. It's pretty long. I can't even get it all in the shot, but yeah, it's pretty long stick, or you can adjust it somewhere halfway. And then once you like the length of it, you just twist this and then it just stays like that. Now, the good thing about the selfie stick and the software in this camera is that as you're recording it, if you're holding it, like don't ever hold it like this. Like some people I've seen them holding it like this and kind of like pointing the camera at themselves. Don't do that. Just hold the camera away from you. And just really the only thing you got to worry about when it comes to 360 cameras is pick your more or less your height or like your angle, I would say, of the shot that you want. So if you want like a low shot looking up at you or looking up at these lights or at the camera, then you go low. If you want it to be a bit higher, just hold it up higher and that's it. If you want it to be eye level, just hold it eye level. Because afterwards you can choose your basically where you're actually pointing the camera and your field of view, well, how much you're zooming in and out. But the cool thing is with your hand, I mean, if you're just going to be like, if I'm recording here, I would probably just hold my hand like this. And then all you're going to see in the final video is just my hand. And then it looks almost like you're just, you know, like you have something there, kind of like a little ball or something in your hand. So that's the great thing is that the stick itself is not visible. So it's great in that way. And it's, and again, it doesn't look like those cheesy selfie sticks of, you know, when people record themselves on their cell phones or even on a GoPro camera. So as you can see, this is a pretty good accessory. It's actually also works as a tripod because the handle turns into a little stand here. You can put the camera and again, you can adjust the height of it. So it's a great little tripod for the camera. Another thing you will actually get, this is included, is this little foam case. Definitely use this because you do not want to scratch these lenses. They're not something that you can change out later on. So you damage the lenses, that's it, the camera's damaged. But with this thing, it's easy to kind of carry it. It comes with those little straps, you can put it around your neck. And it protects the lenses, so which is really good. When it comes to recording, I got nothing bad to say except one thing, and that's the battery life. The battery life in this is about an hour for this battery. So if you're going to be really conservative with the camera, you're going to just turn it on, record, then turn off the camera and wait till you, next time, then I guess you can make it last. But if you're going to be like me, where again, I use this mainly for home video, then, you know, I just want to, again, turn it on and just press record and forget about it. And when I was doing that very quickly, like I said, or it seems like very quickly, the battery is just done and suddenly the camera starts beeping and it turns off on me. So that's the only thing that sucks. There are now, though, a lot of battery options and they can get, whether it's from Insta360 or from other actually manufacturers with like, you know, multiple, like a dual or triple chargers. So I'll provide the links for that if you guys are interested. So yeah, and in that sense, it's like I said, it's a very easy to operate and record camera. Now that's when it comes to home video. But if you were actually planning to do 360 professional video, I can't recommend this. And I can't really recommend any of these 360 cameras. That's because 360 video is still not there. What I mean by that is this resolution is just enough for like home video quality. But if I wanted to actually do a professional project on this, something that's, you know, could later on maybe be displayed on a big screen, or even if it's like a virtual thing where, you know, people would experience it watching it through a VR goggles, I still don't think the quality is there. And it's not even just the resolution, which I think the resolution for like pro video, I think it has to be like minimum 8K, because again, once you stretch that image over 360, you're really getting like 1/4 of that quality. So I think 8K is like, I would say is minimum, but really outside of that, the main thing is just the controls. Because again, like I said, for home video, you want the controls to be simple. For professional work, you want to have full control over the exposure, over white balance, which you cannot do with this camera. And that's a problem, because if I'm shooting like outside where it's kind of more or less the same exposure everywhere, that's not a problem. But if I'm shooting, for example, here in the studio where this part of the studio has all these bright lights, but this part is kind of dim and dark, well, that's a problem, because then the camera doesn't know how to adjust the exposure, and either one part's going to be overexposed or one part's going to be, you know, underexposed. And that's kind of the issue with it. Not to mention, again, like I said, the white balance. It's especially if I start mixing different color temperature lights, I want to be able to go in and manually adjust the white balance, which you cannot do with this or with any of these 360 cameras. So that's definitely something that I hope these camera manufacturers of the, you know, when it comes to 360 cameras, implement in the future. Now, obviously, you're recording in 360, so you don't need a monitor here. But I think you still need to be able to, like, in real time, through the app, kind of monitor and there change the settings, which you can monitor in real time this phone, and it's great for that. But again, you just can't change the settings. Now, that was going to maybe take me to my second part, which is editing and just kind of working with this footage. The app that Insta360 provides, which is both for iOS and Android, is amazing. It's like the best 360 video app from any of these other basically cameras, whether these ones here or other ones that I've tried. And that's because they just make it simple, but they also give you all these features that are really important. What I mean by that is, like I said, outside of just from monitoring the shot, you can, once you're done recording, you can connect this camera to your phone, you can offload the footage there, or you can just view it actually live through Wi-Fi, and then you can, on your phone, actually kind of re-edit the shots, but you can also reframe the shot. So let's say if you're not going to export this as a 360 video, but as a normal, let's say 1080p, kind of a, you know, 16:9 aspect ratio, or whatever other aspect ratio you want. Maybe you want to share this on Facebook or Instagram or your YouTube channel. It's great working with the phone app, because in the phone app, you can easily kind of zoom in, zoom out. You can do your, you know, the little planet kind of a, you know, angle. You can really zoom in on the footage. You can pick your where the, basically you're looking in that 360 environment. And you can also animate that. You can set keyframes very easily, and the software will interpolate between those keyframes, and the video looks beautiful. But another feature that I really love in their app is that you can sort of in real time record your kind of camera moves. So you can actually kind of point your phone up and down, left and right, and kind of pan and tilt the camera that way. But then with your thumb, you can actually zoom in and zoom out. And you can do that all real time while you're watching the video. It's really cool. So again, for home videos, it's amazing, because you can, again, like I said, connect this right away to your phone. Even, you know, while you're there, let's say you just recorded something cool and you want to share this to your Instagram or Facebook or whatever. And the same thing if you're a social, like, kind of a media guru or influencer, and you want to, again, have some cool 360 videos that you can share right away. And again, this is really cool, because you can do that on their app, and it works really well. And right from their app, you can then, it allows you to share on all those social media apps. Now, when it comes to professional video, again, it's not something I would want to be, first of all, doing on my phone, because I'm probably going to have a lot of footage and I want to really kind of like see the details in the shot. And, you know, on your phone, you can only see so much. Not to mention that when I tried using this for kind of more professional work on my phone, I would record a lot of footage, and then I just didn't have enough battery life. Usually, because it does use up a lot of your battery on your phone. But on my phones, whether it's my iPhone or my Android phone, none of them really would allow me to get through all of my footage and then do all my reframing and then export all of it. It was okay for doing it for a few clips, but after that, my battery would die, or I would just run out of space on my phones. So that was another problem, because I'm working with so many files. And so that's why for me, I need to be able to edit video on my laptop or on a computer. And I'll tell you right away, whether it's this camera or any of these other three cameras, working with 360 video these days is still not easy for professional work, like I said, because throwing it on my laptop, first of all, the files are just, you really need a powerful computer. And also then depends on what software you're working with, because it's easier than, you know, without some software than others. Final Cut Pro, I kind of find it's the easiest. You're not going to be able to natively load into Final Cut Pro, but if you install the Insta360 One Studio app, then once you install it on your Mac, then you'll actually be able to then import the files in Final Cut, and then you can reframe the shots and all that stuff. In Adobe Premiere, you again have to install the Insta360 One Studio, and then you can actually see the footage in Adobe Premiere, but you will not be able to still kind of reframe the shots. If you're just gonna export 360 video, yeah, you can do that in Adobe Premiere. But if you actually wanna do export like a flat, let's say 1080p video or standard video, and you wanna just do your reframing, you actually need to install the competitor of this camera, which is the GoPro, has a free plugin, and that plugin will actually allow you in the Adobe Premiere to do your reframing and zooming and all that stuff. And then like I said, you can work with that footage. Now, one thing I found is it's still, unless again you have like super powerful computer, you're not going to be able to edit or play back that footage in Premiere or Final Cut Pro in real time, unless you then render that footage into proxies. So if, you know, if you don't mind taking that extra step and going through all that rendering and converting, then again you can edit that footage. But otherwise, it's even my decent desktop computer that I have, where I can edit like 8K RAW video from the red cameras, I cannot edit this footage in 360. So just be aware of that. So you really are going to need to do proxies, and then that takes time. And again, it's not something that I want to be dealing with when I'm doing professional work. And sometimes I need to quickly get a quick turnaround from when I record the video to when I actually edit it and get it out there to the client. So because of that, it's kind of it's not there when it comes to the post-production aspect. And then if you're editing in a program, which is my favorite editing program and something that I pretty much edit all of my work in, which is DaVinci Resolve, then you're basically screwed, because you cannot get these files at all right now to work in DaVinci Resolve. Now, that might change with time. Hopefully it will. I'm hoping Insta360 can kind of create a desktop app or program that they created for their Android and iOS phones, because if they can create something that's as good as that, because right now when you're using their desktop Insta360 Studio program, it allows you to do reframing, but it's not really for editing. And even there, it's not as smooth and not as cool, intuitive as it is on the phone. So I hope they fix that. I hope they add like some of this tracking feature that you can track objects in the Studio program. So that would be really cool. But also, if they just make it a really good editing software, either that, or if they work really closely with DaVinci Resolve or Adobe Premiere or Final Cut developers and actually make it so that this kind of footage can be easily, natively, right away edited in those applications. So that's where it's still lacking. But again, like I said, if you don't mind just using this for your home video, or like I was using this for kind of my behind the scenes footage, then this thing is really good, because I would usually just put it up on this little stand, you know, and again, you can adjust the height of this, and I would just hit record and just leave it there. So, it was great for that. Now, like I said, the battery life is not great, so you definitely want to pick up extra batteries. I got these kind of actually off-brand batteries that come with a charger. So again, you guys can check out the link for that. And if you want to get the camera, then you can actually get a really good deal, because on Amazon, they're going to have what's called a Prime Day. So if you join and you become a Prime member, then you can actually get 15% discount off of this camera or some of the bundles that they offer there with some of the accessories. So definitely I would recommend checking it out then. And like I said, great little behind the scenes camera, great home video camera. Anyways, that's it for this video. As always, you can check out more information on my website, tomantosfilms.com. And while you guys are there, make sure you don't forget to subscribe to my newsletter, so you stay on top of all the videos that I release, posts, you know, little discounts, giveaways that I do and things like that. Once again, it's tomantosfilms.com. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.